Good evening, A-Life Online and A-Life In-House. Are y'all ready to worship? That's what I'm talking about. Our worship is getting bigger and better every worship Wednesday, but it's never going to be as big or as good as our Lord and Heavenly Father in the heavens. And that's what we're here for, just what He has done for us. He has rescued us. He has created us. He hung the stars in the skies just for us, and we're here to worship Him for that. We worship Jesus because of His humility, His humanity, His deity, all these amazing things about Him, our Creator, the author of our faith. And so when you are worshiping tonight, if for any reason you feel the Spirit upon you, which I hope you do, we've got this down here for you guys to kneel in front of. If you want to just have that that vertical connection with the Lord and just talk directly to Him, and that's what worship and praise is all about. It's just having a communication, a communion with God, and that's what we hope that you guys all have tonight. So we're going to read from Psalm 95, 1 through 6, and then I'll give it up to the ones that were really here to watch. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before Him with thanksgiving and extol Him with music and song. For the Lord is great. The Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods. In His hand are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to Him. The sea is His, for He made it, and His hands formed the dry land. And finally, come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. So I'm going to give it up, guys, and just please worship. Open your hearts and your minds and just release it. Pour your spirit out upon Jesus. Thomas?
Good evening, everybody. Feels different to say good evening. We're just going to spend this next hour asking for the presence of God. And, open your hearts, open your minds, do your best to keep everything else blocked out. And Jorge and Mercedes and Sandra are so gracious enough to help us do this in Spanish also. About worship, like I said on Sundays, that's a language everybody knows. Nicole and I used to join the Spanish service, and it was so amazing hearing what to do.
Gracias a Dios. Dios les bendiga, hermanos, en esta hermosa tarde. Es un placer, un honor, speak Spanish, de estar aquí con ustedes y poder compartir las alabanzas al Señor. Así es que todos los que nos miran quedan realmente invitados para que vengan y se gocen con nosotros esta tarde. Amén. Dios los bendiga.
This is amazing grace. This is a perfect love that you
done for me. Let's do the chorus one more time in Spanish, a little slower. Gracias, sublime.
Thank you.
A newer song. It's an old song, but it's a new song to us. So bear with me if I don't hit all the words. Glorious are you, Lord.
your love, it's your cross.
Stories, but around the Tower of Babylon, There was how many different languages, Jack? Around how many languages was around the Tower of Babylon? There was like 17 languages, and when God spoke, everybody of all those languages heard it the same. Not only about you guys, but I think the Spanish version of that last song was even better than the English. And none of us speak Spanish, right? That's Holy Spirit for you. It's amazing. Let's see what we got here. This is Your Love Never Fails. I'm going to lead Spanish and English, and I can't tell you when I'll be switching back and forth. Hang in there.
Nothing more can tear my
eternamente es para siempre. En tu amor no que cambiará, puede que haya dolor, pero tu trasgozo.
So I want to tell about a little testimony. I'm going to need my beautiful wife down here, Miss Vanna White. I mean, Nicole Shadler. Come on down, baby. She's running the camera, the sound, and the lights. Is there any other senses that she's not doing? So Nicole's telling me today she's had this growth on her face for years and years. We went to the dermatologist about it, and they scraped it off, and it kept growing back. So she told me today, and it was really bad a few days ago, and today it's gone. She said she prayed over it, it's gone. Yeah. So there's two things we can do. One, we can say, well, I hope God healed it, and I hope it doesn't grow back, and I'm going to keep checking, and I'm going to look for any sign that that thing is back. Or we can thank God for what he's done, that he's healed her. And all it took was a prayer, just like a father and son. He loves communication back and forth, whether that means us asking for something, thanking him for something. What matters is that she prayed it and she believed it, and now it's gone. So doctors couldn't do it. He could.
Stop.
we've set this bench up right here. Because there's no place that's higher or greater than at the feet of Jesus.
There is no place that's higher, that's greater than here at your feet, than here at your feet. There is no place that's higher.
Here is Majestad,
mountain I drink from, oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the shadow where I hide. The ransom for my life, oh, he is my song. 'Cause you are we'll be right back.
Thank you. venciste, el velo partiste, la tumba vacía ahora está. Los cielos declaran.
You can tell because I can't talk, but we're going to lift up somebody. As we close the service out, we're actually going to see Bobby off, don't worry, for 2 weeks. We're going to have a different sound on Sunday. You know, I wanted to look and find another drummer. Big shoes to fill. They're size 12s, but they're actually more like size 112 because I was a drummer all the way through school, and I cannot touch what he does. So we're going to go acoustic for the next 2 Sundays. It's going to be a lot of fun, a lot of different sound, but I'd like for us as a church, as this family, to pray over Bobby. He's driving all the way to Texas. He's going to go take care of his mom. Hospice has been called. So we want to protect him spiritually. We want him to know that we're there for him. He's always there for us. So, Jack, would you want to lead prayer for Bobby?
Lord Jesus, we ask that not only do you guide his hands on this journey by your Holy Spirit, Lord God, that you guide everybody around him, God. We know the journey that he's going on, so it's for his mother. I want you to comfort his mother, God. I want you to comfort Bobby throughout this, Lord God, and just know, you know, that Jesus, that Bobby is your servant. He serves on that stage, Lord God. You know that he loves you. So just comfort him, care for him, bring him there safely, Lord God, and bring him back to us. Lord, have him connect his heart with his mother's while he's down there, Lord God. you know that they love each other and both of them love you. Have all your hearts connected together, God, and minister to them all. Lay a blanket over that hospital while he's there, Lord God. Fill that room with your angels and just minister to them, God. We rely on you. You're the ultimate healer. You are the author of our lives, God. Please, please just minister to him throughout this. Lord Jesus, we lift Bobby up right now. And by the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus Christ, I call him safe on his journey. We thank you so very much, God, for giving us Bobby. Thank you. Bring him back to us safely. Allow his journey to be wholesome, fruitful, and memorable. Love, love, love is what he needs to feel. God, we love you so much. So does Bobby. In your holy name we pray. Amen. Amen, Bobby. Church, thank you for being a part of that with me. Just remember that presence that you feel right now. Experience that every day of your life. When you go home, worship before you go to bed. When you wake up, before you have your breakfast cereal in the morning, worship Jesus. Continue to worship Jesus and just feel that power all day long. Feel him with you. Feel him with you. I love you guys. I'm going to pray one last time. Heavenly Father, dear God, before these people leave this building, I want you to mend their spirits, their hearts, their minds, their souls, Lord God, and bring all of them unto you tonight, Lord God. Speak to them in their dreams. Tell them where they're supposed to go, what they're supposed to do. But more than anything else, keep their eyes on you, Jesus. We love you so much. We worship your holy name. We worship you, Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We love you, God. We give you all the glory and all the honor. In your name, the holy name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Thanks, guys. Be blessed. Be blessed tonight. Stay in the presence. Thank you, team. Thank you, Thomas. Thank you, guys.